know what it is.
Yes.
You know
what I mean? Sorry about the long wait, y'all, and the repeats.
No doubt. We're going to definitely bring DJ Boo Man. He's going to be having the mixes in between. You know what I mean? New format. You know what I'm saying? We sharpening things up. So, time for some action. Go ahead, my brother. You know what I'm saying? There you go.
All right. But like I said, I don't want to sound corny, man, because everybody say this. You know what I mean?
Say what?
I'm going to say, man, my homeboy, Scar, is in the house. I mean, he's here, y'all. I mean, you know, and I ain't trying to really, you know, ride him like that. Pause.
You know what? I asked him while we was coming up here, I asked him about, because a lot of the young boys, the first thing you ask is what they influence, especially from here,
right,
and they say Scar. So I said, Scar, how does it feel to be, you not gone yet, and you a B more legend?
Right.
So can you speak a little bit about that?
I don't, like, that whole like, little situation, I really don't get it.
Right.
Like, I'm still doing me, like, so, like,
right,
I feel like I'm still in the race with y'all.
Right.
But how a person looks at me, I don't get it, because I'm still eye level with everybody. Like,
right,
I don't look down on no person. I don't look up to no person.
So, right,
so like, when they said it to me, I was like, not in no disrespectful way, I just brush it off, because I feel like I'm still in the race with them.
Right. Well, a lot of them are 80 babies. So,
yeah,
you know what I'm saying? They dads had your mixtape, you know what I'm saying, bumping in their car.
Right.
So I think that's where it comes from, influence. But I think another thing I want to say is there's a lot of rappers that came out of Baltimore, but you seem to be like one of the dudes that's in the forefront. Why do you think that is?
I can't tell you, bro. I actually really can't tell you. I guess because...
What about your grind? What do you think about your grind?
I think it's impeccable.
Right, no doubt.
Because at the end of the day, like, it's... I'm one person. I'm a one-man army.
Right.
Like, so I do everything. Any and everything that you could think of, I do. And I do it just off of passion, ambition, and drive. Like,
right.
To not want to have to ask anybody to do anything for me or wait on another person. So, like...
Right.
I don't know, it's like, it's embedded in my head just to go out there and get it. Like,
right,
don't wait. I'm not waiting for anybody to do anything for me. Like, I'm going to go get it. Like, I'm going to meet the people. I'm going to touch the people. I'm going to have fun doing it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I always been ambitious. I always been that guy. And I don't understand the word no or I can't.
Right.
So, like, I guess so, this is it.
So, let me ask you this. May rest in peace.
Mm-hmm.
You know, your homeboy, our friend.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Smash.
I just told him this.
Yeah, we just talking about
this
him.
Office, this spot that y'all in right now,
right,
was his office.
Spirit.
Yeah.
But you wanna, it drew us here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's good.
But to get, I don't wanna sound
just speak
like
on it, bro. That's
okay,
it.
Listen.
Yeah.
He passed, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So much. You could just see in your rhymes now that he's passed. I don't know if that had a lot to do with it. You got a lot more passion than I ever seen you rhyme before. When he was alive, I mean, you were Scar. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you was out like our nigga, like, yo, this nigga bringing it.
Right.
But now you touching us in our heart. And I seen that after he passed away. I mean, did that have a lot to do with the way you're perceiving yourself now?
That plays a factor, and like that, yo, that shit killed me. That shit hurt like a mother. That shit really hurt, because whether nobody know, like, I'm from West Baltimore. I grew up, me and him grew up in the Irvington area, flipping on mattresses and just chilling. So like, yeah, I know, yo, like, I know his real name, you know what I'm saying? Like, but that played a major part, and it's just me going through so much in life and be able to speak on it, like, to turn myself inside out and, okay, this is me. The person that y'all know or hear about, the rumors y'all hear about, whatever else y'all hear about me, I'm gonna tell y'all why I'm like this. So it just let me, it just made me become an open book, like, not afraid to speak on things and take the criticism, because I am who I am. Like, I really don't give a fuck. Like, I am who I am, but his death, like, I don't know, yo. I experienced a lot of deaths, homeboys, but like no one close like that besides my cousin Andre. So that was another person, like, falls in the quote unquote rap world. Mm-hmm. I'm saying, like, a person that he'd call me about music, But we touch on so many different things. It's like, yo, I just said that, blah, 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 blah. We just sit there and talk about stuff. Like I said, so like, I had a relationship. Like, our relationship was beyond music. It was deeper than that. So like, right. Yeah, that touched me. Like, that shit really hurt me.
Yeah. And you can really, really tell just the dedications that you have given to him through your rhymes. And like, I respect you so much for that, man. Like, you always keep him relevant, you know what I mean? And even though his music is out here and people do respect him and do play his shit, but for you, you know what I mean? It's like, I look at you like you are his true friend. You know what I'm saying? Like, I look at everything you have done since he's passed, and I respect you for that, man. You know what I mean? And we know you. You know what I'm saying? We know you. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of people that's out there in the world that hears about you, people up top, you know, New York, you know, that's our neighbors, Philly.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of cats respect you in those states. When you go up top, how it feel for you to be recognized, especially in New York, the way they recognize you up there?
It's cool. Like, I had my, like, at an early stage, like, at a young stage, like, I had my bumps and bruises up there, like, I had to go through, you know what I mean? But, like, now it's like, I think they hear the authenticity of a true artist, like, I mean, like, street nigga artist. Like, they just hear, they respect it. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm one of them. Mm-hmm. I'm from Baltimore, but I'm just one of them. I play a part of real MC and real hip hop. Like, I'm just cut from that cloth. They just see it. It feels good.
Yeah, and the thing that I seen that you do, it bugged me out, because I always said that we're just like New York in our own way.
Mm-hmm.
We did the same thing. New York lost their identity a long time ago.
Right.
And so did we. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But you knew how to connect with the people that was real up there. And just watching you on some of them videos, like, I'm rooting, like, we down here, like, yo. You know what I'm saying? Like, all of us, you know, Crooked Streets, the whole family. I mean, we know New York like the back of our hand. Right. You know what I'm saying? But for you to go up there and to be around all the legends, you know what I'm saying? And then they look at you and they feel you. That's like, you put Baltimore in that spot. You know what I'm saying? That made us look like, you know what I mean? And I don't care what nobody else say. You know what I mean? Just because I know Scar, I'm going to get credit where it's due. You know what I'm saying?
I appreciate it.
You know what I mean? Listen, he might not want me talking this, but we used to run a club called Hip Hop Cafe. And for everybody to know what that spot was about, it was like, you come, we're going to represent you. But this man comes to the spot with like 400 niggas. And I never in my life seen, okay, of course, you know, you see the gray hair. We older than Scar. You know what I'm saying? But Scar came in there like a gentleman. Like, had so many young soldiers behind him that you ain't had nothing to do but respect him. Like, it was amazing. And the way you didn't, like I said, I ain't riding you. I'm just giving credit where it's due. That's a real motherfucker right there, man. You know what I mean? And a lot of people respect you for that. You know what I'm saying? Just so how you used to come in there and just have you know, sometimes they would act up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But for you to, okay, this is their house. You know, you let them know that this is our house.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all got to respect that. And then you had all the other rappers that coming in, rapping. Who was it? Ogun.
Mm-hmm.
Diablo.
Mm-hmm. Oh, damn. Oh, my God.
Street Pie Army. Kool-Aid.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of these people, Street Pie and Army ain't the Street Pie and Army that y'all representing out there. Street Pie and Army was a hip hop group. It wasn't a gang. You know what I'm saying? But Zone 18 is where I'm from, and everybody know that it was a lot of MCs around there. Shout out to Diablo. Did that joint with Sirius Jones. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Just knowing that you was around that cat too.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like, when you go and you make those moves, do you just get up and just go, or you plan it like, this is where I'm going at?
It, like, sometimes if I can't plan things because I'll overthink it. So sometimes I just like, yo, go. See what's up. Like, go. Like, just go. I'm saying, that's how it just has to be that way, because if you think about something too much, you second guess yourself about the what ifs and you chill. I'm getting too old to chill. Yeah, you know I'm saying, like, it's not none of that for real. Like, and I think I started young, like real young.
Can you tell them how young you started? Because I think that put everything in perspective. How young was you when you started?
When I came on the Baltimore scene, mm-hmm. I probably was 15.
Wow.
I think I was 15, but I was lyrically, I was just raw.
Why do you think it's so hard nowadays to find a 15-year-old that has that talent, or is it just that we're just overlooking them because of social media?
You're overlooking them. He's being overlooked. Like, it's just, hey, it's some little guys out here that could go. You know what I'm saying? But, like, social media plays a part in a world that really doesn't exist with him, because he's nurtured by where we came from,
right,
and the aspects of that era.
Right.
So, like, he really doesn't care about that type of exploitation. Like, right. I really don't care about it.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, that's just how it is, for real. Right. Like, but it's trust me, it's a little dude out here that gets busy.
Right, they definitely get busy. Now you just said, we just got finished talking about social media. Nowadays, it is two different rappers. It is the guys who depend on social media, and it's the guys who don't depend on social media. And you already said you're not the guy that depends on it. What do you think about the guy who does depend on social media to get where he got to go at?
It's a 50-50 thing, because you gotta understand, social media touches continents.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a gateway. Your arms are longer.
Right.
And potentially your fan base could be bigger.
Right.
But if your music is not where it's supposed to be, you gravitate to more so the dummies that's out there that's gravitate to shit. Like, music is fickle down to me. Like, it's crazy.
Right.
It's really crazy. And you don't have to work hard or, you know, practice on your craft to be popular.
Right.
You have to say something that fits a certain criteria, and people jump onto the shit.
Right.
So it's a lot of people like that in social media that picks that up. But it's also people that's on social media that really will bash that shit and really love the authenticness of real lyrics, real beats.
Now keep it right there for a minute, though.
Go ahead.
You know what I mean? It's time for some action. We'll be right back. We're going to talk about that, because that was the next joint.
Oh, we just segue into that. Okay, that's what it is.
We're going to keep it. We'll be right back.
All
right.